Right now, some of our biggest challenges are wait times and access to care. The ultimate vision is to improve the trajectory of cancer care for patients in Alberta, which means ensuring patients have access to state-of-the-art care when they need it, and that we tailor it to meet the needs of individual patients.
I was diagnosed with a rare form of brain cancer in 2013. My main goal was to be around for my family, especially my then 3-year-old daughter, for as long as possible. So I was fortunate that by the time I finished the radiation part of my treatment, which was 6 weeks, and I received a new care team. In fact, they fully engaged me and invited me in. It gave me the comfort in knowing that I did have ownership over this cancer and it wasn't owning me.
Using AI on large data sets enable us to embrace the complexity of cancer care. Our current work includes over 300,000 cancer diagnoses, approximately 13 million cancer-specific visits, 200 gigabytes of lab data, and more than 7 million imaging encounters. That's the magnitude of the data we're talking about to implement what we call precision analytics, which includes predictive AI modeling. This allows us to improve our decision-making about resource and staff allocation, and it will help us to expand access, reduce wait times, and improve care.
Cancer is a non-linear disease. With artificial intelligence, we can overcome the inherent limitations of linear models. My research focuses on radiomics, using imaging to predict outcomes. We have built an AI model which extracts more than 5,000 features from CT images to predict survival outcomes in patients. With our early data, the model is already a better predictor than staging. It goes beyond looking at the cancer alone, but rather also at the overall condition of the patient.
To me, the best way that care teams and health systems can support the cancer patient is recognizing that the cancer patient and their families are the experts on them. And we know what we're feeling, we know what we're experiencing. When we are listened to, heard, and engaged, we feel empowered. And by feeling empowered, we are able to face cancer on a much stronger stance.
Time is precious for cancer patients. Increasing the pace to implement innovation, that's not just an option. It's an obligation we have to our patients.